Good morning. Thanks for tuning in. You're watching the F&O show on Bloomberg Quint Live, India's first digital live streaming business news service. I'm Navneet Saluja D'Souza.
Good morning, Navneet. I'm Agam Akhil. First, the headlines. Markets have begun the new trading week on a negative note. The Nifty falls below its 50 DMA and the 11,500 mark. All in sectoral indices are trading with losses. Open interest has surged in Mindtree as traders take fresh short positions in the stock futures. And auto stocks are the top losers on the Nifty, extending their losses from Friday after the budget hiked custom duty on certain input parts. And Punjab National Bank is trading with losses after it reported a 3,800 crore loss from Bhushan Power and Steel.
All right, those are the top headlines for you with this hour. Let's also tell you what's happening with the markets and particularly in the futures and options market. We've had a gap down opening owing to global markets at least today, and the Asian markets were deep into red this morning, and Nifty is down about 1% right now, trading around the level of about 11,700, which got breached in today's session. In fact, they're selling across the board. You've also got the broader market indices, which have seen cuts in today's trade. The mid-cap and the small-cap indices are seeing cuts between 1 to 1.3%. All sectoral indices are trading in the red, with losses led by autos, which is down sharply for the second straight session. PSU Bank, remember, this was inching higher because of the recap news, but I think that's priced in now. The PSU banks are now sliding lower, 3.5% cut seen for the Nifty PSU Banking Index, and Realty, which was moving higher in anticipation of some bit of announcement coming in the budget, that too is seen profit booking today. That's down about 1.5%. The market breadth is very weak this Monday morning. In fact, if you look at the market breadth right now, the advance decline ratio, it's almost 1:6 on National Stock Exchange. So picture is not looking great at all. And the Nifty is trading below its 20 and the 50-day moving average. But as we've been highlighting, there is some bit of outperformance seen from the banking index, that's Bank Nifty. Though that's trading lower, it is still trading above all its key moving averages like 20 or the 50-day moving average. In fact, Bank Nifty is still trading 2% away from its all-time high levels. Let's look at the options data, what sort of levels one should watch out for. Very interesting data coming this morning will be the Nifty PCR. On Friday, the closing was somewhere about 1.09, and the Bloomberg currently indicates, I think, the Nifty PCR has slipped below that mark of about 1 because there is more call writing which is coming in the system. Can that be a sign of markets being in an oversold territory? We'll find from our experts. But clearly, Agam, there is more call writing seen in the system, and that's clearly visible around the marks of about 11,700 and the 11,800. And the higher level put strikes, where open interest addition was seen in the last week, I think put writers are running for cover, unwinding scene for the 11,750 and the 11,800
strikes.
That's
exactly more concerning, if we can go back to that slide, because, you know, until a few days ago, we were actually seeing a lot of writing around the 12,000 and 12,100, 12,200 calls. But today, all of a sudden, we started to see writing around the 11,800, 11,900 calls as well. So, of course, that could be a matter of concern, as Navneet was pointing out. But let's talk about stocks. And again, as Navneet has suggested, the advance decline ratio is not encouraging at all this morning. In fact, for all the stocks which are actually looking at an increase in open interest, where we are starting to see declines in the underlying. So while, of course, Mindtree is right at the top of the list, it's down 11%, and this is after the heads, Rostov Ravanan, as well as several other directors, have decided to step down from the company and the positions in the company. That's the reason why we're looking at massive shorts there. Just Allen and NIT Technologies are also looking at marginal declines, and something like a Siemens, perhaps an advance of a little over 0.5%. But Apollo Tyres once again looking weak, and we do have a lot of increase in open interest towards fresh shorts. But in this list, I'm going to keep an eye on Mindtree. Are we looking at substantial unwinding? Let's pull that list up as well, and not too much. Well, Kotak Mahindra Bank holding on. We are looking at longs unwinding. But after that, again, while we have weakness in Asian Paints, HCL Technologies, ICICI Bank, not too much to speak for otherwise. Pardon me, HCL Technologies is actually advancing, one of the few stocks which are bucking the trend this morning, up around 2%. But Navneet, it's going to be about stocks which were impacted because of the budget, of course, the auto sector, and Mindtree, because we have seen the step down from
the old guard.
Yes.
Yep, I think that's perceived as the negative news by the markets because there's a sharp sell-off seen in the stock and fresh shorting also coming on that stock. Besides Mindtree, of course, we'll take views from our experts whether the stock is headed lower from current levels or not, but there are some other stocks that we want to take views on as well. Punjab National Bank, that's your top F&O loser for the day. In fact, the stock's breached its 200-day moving average today after the bank reported 2,800 crore fraud by Bhushan Power and Steel. The other stock which is in focus is Hero Motor Corp, which is down for the second straight session, and the stock continues to trade around its 52-week low mark. In fact, on year-to-date basis, it has been an underperformer, down 22%. And Siemens, which was down 7-8% on Friday, has recovered from the lows. The stock has seen some bit of recovery today, and it also trades above all its key moving averages. Agam, it's also one of the outperformers on Y-to-D basis. We have seen returns of about 22% here.
Well, Punjab National Bank is an extremely important counter to keep an eye on. And are we expecting more, well, seepage in terms of a more systemic risk? That's a question that, of course, that fundamental analyst will answer. But it's time to get in our F&O experts. But before that, here's a reminder, if you have any queries regarding futures and options markets, you can call us on 022-454-0414 or, of course, write to us on Twitter, Facebook and YouTube with the AskBQ hashtag. To get in our experts for the day, then, we have Kunal Shah of Indiabulls Ventures and Sneha Seth of Angel Broking joining us on the show. Good morning to both of you, and thanks for taking the time out. Kunal, let's start with you. More weakness in store. How are you looking at trends develop this morning?
See, overall, talking on the index front, I think 11,800 on the Nifty was a very crucial support, which it has breached decisively today. Any close or trade below 11,800 definitely makes the markets weak. So at the current juncture, where we have seen a gap down opening and a more than 100 plus point fall into the index, I think at the current juncture, definitely selling is not risk reward wise favorable at the current levels. Yes, utilize bounces again to sell the index till the time it doesn't close above 11,900 kind of a level. So now we have seen aggressive call writings even happening at 11,900, 12,000 strike, which already has seen some great accumulation. So even for the weekly expiry, 12,000 and 11,900 seems to be a stiff resistance on the upside. Don't expect Nifty to go above those levels. So at the current juncture, I think the ideal way would be to deploy a strategy. One can definitely go for a bear put strategy in Nifty. Since Nifty has breached the crucial support levels, Nifty can test levels of 11,600 to 11,550 on the downside. So at the current juncture, the safe bet would be to go for a bear put spread. This strategy is initiated when someone has a bearish view on the market, where you sell you buy a one lot of put option and you sell a one lot of put option. So at the current juncture, I would advise one to buy a 11,700 put option and to sell a 11,600 put option. At the current juncture, the spread is trading at around 30 rupees. One can see an upside of 70 to 100 rupees on the upside if the market again still goes down towards the levels of 11,600. The maximum risk that one can bear in the strategy is 30 rupees. So I think even risk reward wise, it is more than 1:2. So at the current juncture, it looks a very attractive strategy since Nifty has broke down from the crucial support zone. So utilize bounces again to sell the index. But at the current juncture, one can definitely be safe and deploy the strategy at the current levels. For Bank Nifty, the view still remains bearish, but I think Bank Nifty needs to break 31,000. 31,000 is a very crucial support which Bank Nifty was holding since the previous 2 to 3 months. And even with fall in Nifty, Bank Nifty has still not breached 31,000 on the downside. So I think once 31,000 is breached for Bank Nifty, then you can see some aggressive selling coming into the Bank Nifty index. A 1,000-point fall can take Bank Nifty even towards the levels of 30,000 kind of a zone. So wait for Bank Nifty at the current juncture. I would say avoid, sell only below if the Bank Nifty future closes below 31,000. So if 31,000 is breached on the downside, then definitely initiate fresh sell into the Bank Nifty index. You can even see levels of 30,300 to 30,000 on the downside.
Okay, so initiate fresh shots in Bank Nifty only if it breaches the mark of 31,000, and Kunal is recommending a bear put spread on Nifty for the day. Let's go across to Sneha and find out what is her strategy on these benchmark indices. Hi, Sneha. Good morning. The PCR has been inching lower. It's around the level of 1. In fact, the current data also indicates it may have breached the level of 1. Does it indicate we are in an oversold territory? How would you approach the index right now?
Good morning. If we see the put call ratio, which is now at 1, it's been quite long that we haven't seen put call ratio going below 1. And now, what the reason behind put call ratio going down is writing, which we are seeing from last two sessions, especially. Today, writing is also seen in 11,700, 11,800 call options. But what I see is, on Friday, what kind of fall we saw, in that we saw hardly 1% of open interest addition in case of Nifty. If you look at the options activity, 11,700 put option holds maximum open interest as of now. And despite such a sharp fall, we are not seeing any unwinding in that particular strike. In fact, 11,650 put is again adding some fresh positions, and I believe that can be writing. So at present for me, 11,650, 11,700 is a support zone. I would avoid any kind of trade as of now, but any recovery above 11,700 in the second half, and if Nifty sustains above 11,730, 740 during the end of the day, then we can, you know, take a positive bet and trade in index. As of now, we would avoid trading, and we would like to wait and watch for the next couple of hours.
Fair
in
enough.
Case of banking.
All right. Yeah. Go on, Sneha, please.
In case of banking index, again, 30,800 is a very good support zone. Banking index was outperforming on Friday. We haven't seen any kind of a shorting today. However, both Nifty and Bank Nifty are adding some shorts, but we'll have to see in the later half how it reacts, and then we can go ahead and trade in index, especially.
Okay, well, so for now, Sneha is looking to avoid taking any positions, at least as far as the index is concerned, the Nifty specifically. She wants to wait before she can go long on the indices, provided the fact that the Nifty goes and advances above, well, 11,700, 11,730 odd levels. But Sneha, that said, I'll come back to you. If you can also talk to us about stocks that are looking interesting to you.
Stock specifically, if you look at ITC, your ITC around 270, 272 is a very good support zone. From there, we have seen recovery. On Friday's session, this counter has gone up, and we have also seen fresh longs adding. On Friday, in fact, 280, that was a hurdle, and we surpassed those level with a long formation. So it is a positive indication for us. So I believe we can go long in this counter at current levels for the target of 292 and a stop loss of 275. Apart from this, if we look at Century Textile, this counter is showing weakness since last three sessions and has been adding decent shorts. So I expect this counter to correct further. One can go short in this counter for the target of 324 and one can go short in this counter for the target of 880 or 875 zone, and one can maintain a stop loss of 933.
Okay, those are some stock specific strategies coming from Sneha. Kunal, what about you in terms of individual stock futures for this morning? What would you trade into?
See, at the current levels, I have one buy and one sell. My first buy would be Apollo Hospital. The stock in the recent part had given a fresh breakout, and now the stock has retraced and is trading near the crucial support levels of 1290. So I think as long as 1290 is hold, we can see some bounce again coming towards the levels of 1340, 1315 kind of a zone on the upside. So I think in the near term, when the markets are looking dicey, I think Apollo Hospital can be one of the safe bet which one could place at the current juncture, with a good risk reward at the current level. So I think one can buy Apollo Hospital with a stop loss of 1290 for targets of 1340 to 1350 on the upside. So that would be my first pick on the buy side. My sell pick would be Exide Industries. The stock has already seen in a weak trend, and the stock has seen bounces that have failed in the recent past. So I think again the stock is trying to make a new low, and again fresh open interest has been built up on the short side. So I think any recoveries into the stock again would be a good opportunity to initiate fresh short. So Exide Industry would be my sell pick. One can sell at the current levels with a stop loss of 204 for targets of 192 to 188 on the downside. The time horizon for all the calls would be 2 to 3 days, but at the current juncture, my buy call would be on Apollo Hospital and the sell would be on Exide Industries.
Okay, well, that's as far as you know, some of the stocks that our experts want to talk about. Well, we have to address Mindtree because we do know that Rostov Ravanan has stepped down as a CEO, the CEO, Parthasarathy, as well as, the chairman of the company, Natarajan, have all stepped down. So three founding members of Mindtree won't be a part of Mindtree anymore after 17th of July. That is their last date in the company. Because of that, we have seen severe weakness. In fact, from the levels of around 980, which L&T had provided for as a open offer for Mindtree, it's come off quite substantially. As you can see, it's down 19% in the last 1 month. It's currently at 785. A lot of weakness there, a lot of volumes in cash markets too, and off late, not necessarily just today. The real question is, what do we do, and is there more weakness in store for Mindtree, or would you want to avoid taking any positions? So Kunal, coming back to you, your view on Mindtree, how would you address this?
See, at the current levels, definitely the stock has breached the crucial support levels. The next support for the stock stands around the levels of 760. So if you want to take a fresh trade, I think utilize bounces to go short into the stock. At the current juncture, I would say avoid, but utilize bounces towards the levels of 800-805 kind of a zone. You can again initiate fresh shorts with a stop loss of 820 on the upside for target of 760 on the downside, where the support lies. Now 760 is a very crucial support where the stock previously had seen some bounce. So even if 760 is breached and the stock closes below that, then definitely the trend has reversed and we will see some significant downside coming into the stock. So anybody even holding the stock should look at levels of 760. If 760 is breached decisively on a closing basis, then definitely all longs into the stock should be exited.
Okay, that's a sharp sell-off actually that you're seeing in Mindtree in today's session, down 11 to 12%. The other top F&O loser for the day is Punjab National Bank, and of course that one too is lower on back of some news. Just want to correct, at the start of the show we said the fraud amount was 2,800 crore. It's actually 3,800 crore, which the company has reported towards Bhushan Power and Steel, and the stock has reacted negatively to that. Shorting scene on the futures side, and those are the details, by the way, which are on your screen with regard to the breakup of the 3,800 crore fraud. Sneha, if I could come to you, it's also breached its 200-day moving average. If I'm not mistaken, I think it's trading below that in today's session. How would you approach this one? Does this warrant a fresh sell at current levels? Or let's say if somebody was already holding a short position in PNB, what target would you watch out now on the downside?
See, PNB has been correcting. If we see the daily chart, there was a trend line resistance from there in itself. From last 2 days, this counter has been correcting. Today it has opened with a gap down, and again it is follow-up selling is also seen. Presently around 73-72 is a support zone. However, looking at the selling in today's session, I expect it to correct further, possibly towards say 68 or say 67 levels. So anyone who is holding any shorts, they can expect a target around 67 and stick to the sell call.
Okay, well, there you have it. And it's, you know, it's going to be a tough few next days, certainly for PNB and Mindtree, two of these companies that Navneet and I have discussed. Let's move on and address Hero Motor Corp as well. It's currently trading at a 52-week low. We have seen a lot of weakness in auto companies, and Hero Motor Corp is also one of the top losers on the Nifty 50 today. We have seen about a 4.5% increase in open interest on a 3-month basis. As per the indications here, it's well away from its crucial daily moving averages. It's also declined by around 7%, but a lot of that weakness has come only in the last 2 weeks, as evident on your screens right now. Currently, the cash market stock is at around 2,397, around 2,400, so like slightly below 2,400 rupees per share. Kunal, how would you address this one? What's your view? What levels would you watch out for?
See, overall, talking about the auto pack, definitely they have been in a beating down space. Even Hero Moto is in the same space. At the current juncture, the stock has breached the crucial support. We can see some further downside towards the levels of 2260 kind of a zone. Now again, 2260 has been a previous crucial support and it was a resistance. Even if you look at the long term chart from where it had given a fresh breakout and a rally had started. So I think 2260 is now a very crucial support for the stock on the downside. At the current juncture, I would say yes, still there is a 100 points kind of a fall still left into the stock from the current levels. So one can definitely look to short the stock at the current levels and look for levels of 2260 on the downside. From there, we need to see how does the stock react to the support levels. Is there any formation on base formation happening around those levels? Then we can see some again uptrend into the stock. But at the current levels, it definitely remains on the sell side. Utilize again bounces even into the stock for selling side. Even 2500 kind of a call option has been seeing writing happening at even those levels. So I think 2450, 2500 is now a crucial resistance zone on the upside. Any bounce towards the levels of 2400 should be again sold off, and you can see levels of 2260 coming on the downside. So at the current juncture, it's definitely a sell.
Okay, at the current juncture, it is a sell, and also Kunal is advising on every rise, you can look to short Hero Motor Corp, which is trading very weak in today's session. The stock's down about close to 5%, fresh shorting also seen. Before we move to viewer queries, I just want to address one more stock, and that's Siemens, which was weak in Friday's session. It was down about 7% in trade. We did see some bit of recovery in the morning session. I think the stock's once again fallen from the high levels, at least, of the day. It's down about 1%. 7% higher when it comes to open interest. But remember, with this fall, the stock is still trading above all its key moving averages, at least till now. And we have seen outperformance from Siemens on Y2D basis. The stock has given you returns of about 20 to 22%. But Sneha, considering the fall that one has seen on Friday, today also, it's off the highs of the morning session. Would you advise taking any position into this counter?
Sorry, but may I know the counter?
Siemens.
Simmons.
Stock actually opened in the positive territory after the fall that we had seen, but at higher levels, as we indicated currently, if you look at the intraday chart of Siemens, it is trading in the red and almost at the lower level. 1245 last week, the stock was trading somewhere about levels of 1360, so it's fallen almost 80 to 90 points from the highs that we had seen last week. Sneha, on the charts, if you could advise our viewers, is there any position that can be taken here?
Yeah, if we see on Friday session what correction we have seen in there, the volumes were quite good, and today again we are seeing some follow-up selling coming in. Possibly this counter can correct towards 1190, 1195 levels. So I believe one can, any bounce in this counter during a day, one can go ahead and short this counter with a stop loss of today's high, that is 1283.
Okay, I think we can move on and take a few queries. I think one of them is perhaps a pertinent one. We have one from Manikant. He says that he has bought the 31,700 weekly call of the Bank Nifty. That is the call which will expire this particular week, in this particular week. And now, he says that the option levels have come off quite drastically, naturally, considering we are looking at a significant correction in the Bank Nifty today. His question is, should I hold, average, or exit? So, Kunal, let's talk about this specific call. What would you do? He's talking about the 31,700 call, which is now a bit away from that particular mark. Of course, previously on Friday, it closed at around 31,500, but we are not anywhere close to that level anymore. Would you ask him to book a loss? Hold on to this specific option, or perhaps average and buy another option here?
See, exactly at the start of the show, we discussed Bank Nifty is holding the levels of 31,000. So my advice to him would be wait for today's trading session at the end. If Bank Nifty closes below 31,000, then definitely it's an exit. And even on an intraday basis, even if Bank Nifty holds the support of 31,000 and you get bounce towards the levels of 31,200, 300 kind of a zone, I would still say utilize that bounce again to exit the call option. Don't expect Bank Nifty in the weekly expiry even to trade above the level of 31,500. side. Some fresh call writing has been seen at those levels. So Bank Nifty again faces stiff resistance, probably in a range between 31,000 to 31,500 kind of a zone. Overall, yes, at the current juncture, buying a call option is quite risky, because if Bank Nifty breaks 31,000, you can see some sharp downfall into the index. So my advice to him would be wait for today's close. If Bank Nifty closes below 31,000, then also it's an exit position. And if you get a bounce on an intraday basis, 100 to 200 points bounce in Bank Nifty, then definitely again I would say exit the position either at the cost price or whatever minimal loss he is bearing on it.
Okay, that's on Bank Nifty. I'm going to start taking some queries from Facebook as well. Girish Kumar writes to us and he's asking, are stocks Havells and Canara Bank good shorting candidates or not? Sneha, would you advise somebody to short into stocks like Canara Bank or Havells at current levels?
Yeah, if we see the stock Havells, this counter was trading in a range of, say, 800 on the higher side and, say, 770 on the lower side. It has corrected below those level on Friday, and then today we are again seeing some follow-up selling. So one can short this counter for the target of, say, around 720 to 718 zone, and can maintain a stop loss of, say, today's high.
That's the view on Havells. We'll get back to you on Canara Bank, Sneha, but for the time being, Kunal, if I could come to you and take your view on a stock like UPL, which has been volatile in the recent past, would you advise taking any trade there?
I think exactly what you mentioned, UPL has been very volatile in the recent times. In the past 1 week, we saw a 15 to 20% downfall into the stock, and now the stock is recovering fully. So I think at the current juncture, the stock is probably trying to trade in a range. I don't expect further upside into the stock and not further downside into the stock. So probably it's a consolidation phase that the stock would be witnessing in the near term. I utilize support and resistance again to initiate fresh buy and fresh sell at the current level. So the stock will give you both the opportunities if you are a trader. On the upside, the resistance for the stock stands around the levels of 990 kind of a zone, and for the support on the downside is at 870. I know the range is too big at the current levels, but I think even if you get bounced towards the levels of 700, 750 kind of a zone, then again you can initiate fresh short. And even if the stock comes down towards the levels of 600 kind of a zone, you can initiate a fresh buy. So it's stuck in a range at the current levels. So I think better to avoid the stock. If you get at the crucial support or resistance level, then it is a tradable action stock.
Okay. We wanted to go back to Canara Bank, and I think Sneha was taking a look at it. It's poised very interestingly, pardon me, because what we've seen over the past few weeks is that Canara Bank has not only, you know, come off and taken support from its crucial daily moving averages, but it's actually moved well away. And it is only today, for the first time in perhaps 3 or 4 weeks, is where we are actually seeing such severe intraday weakness. So, the question is, what do we do? And of course, Girish Kumar wants to know whether or not it is a good time to sell Canara Bank, which is down 4% already. Sneha, would you recommend Girish to sell Canara Bank?
Now, if you look at the weekly chart of Canara Bank here, we are seeing that there is a falling trend line. And at same levels, this counter has taken a resistance. And from there, we are seeing some selling coming in. Possibly there can be profit booking which can take this counter towards, say, 267, 265 levels. So it is only for profit booking. We are not expecting any major correction from here on. So if he wants to sell for a day or two, then for the target of, say, 665, 667, he can sell this counter.
Okay, that's Canara Bank for you. One more query coming in on YouTube from a handle called RB. And RB has shorted 11,800 call strike of Nifty at a premium of about 87. And he's very much in the money. What he wants to know is whether he should shift his position now towards selling the 11,700 call, considering the index has breached that mark in today's trade. Kunal, going to come to you. What would you advise him to do? Should he hold on to the existing position, which is pretty much in the money, or he should now shift that writing of 11,800 call to 11,700 now?
I think at the start of the show, we mentioned 11,800 was a very crucial support which the index has breached. I think the strike which he has chosen at the current juncture is appropriate. 11,800 will now act as a very stiff resistance on the upside for the index. So I think he is on the right strike. He should maintain and continue to hold that strike rather than even being more aggressive on 11,700. So 11,800 at the current juncture is a very appropriate strike where he has shorted the call option. I think hold for the call option, you will see expiry below the level of 11,800 since Nifty has breached the support of 11,800 on the downside. So if till the time Nifty doesn't close above 11,800, don't expect any upside into the index in the near term. Even we can see Nifty testing levels of 11,650-600 on the downside. So I think my advice to him would be hold the short call option which he has initiated.
Okay, hold on to 11,800 call strike. That's what the advice coming in from Kunal. One more query on Tata Motors. Brijesh Pandya on Facebook wants to know how are the technicals of this one panning out. Remember, the auto pack has been weak. Sneha, on the charts, would you advise anyone to take a position in Tata Motors? The counter today trades with cuts of about 2 to 2.5%.
Looking at the correction seen in the overall auto pack, I would advise avoiding any kind of a position as of now for Tata Motors or any other auto packs unless and until we see some change in the data or same change in the chart structures.
Hey, all right. Well, to take a moment to thank both our experts, Neha and Kunal, for joining us and taking us through their views on the markets and solving a lot of our viewer queries. For more updates on the F&O space, you can also check our website, our BloombergQuint.com, specifically the futures and options pages.
Well, with that, it's a wrap on this edition of the F&O show. Thanks a lot for watching, but you can stay tuned to Bloomberg Quint for more news and updates.